Hey, it's Professor Dave. I want to tell you about the universe.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Of all the things that make us human, it is perhaps our quest for knowledge that defines us best. We never seem to be satisfied with the unknown, always searching, always trying to make sense of our surroundings and our place amongst them. One thing that has instilled wonder in us since the dawn of mankind has been the simple act of looking up at the night sky. Today, we know quite a lot about stars and planets and galaxies, and yet the sight remains awe-inspiring. But imagine looking up at the night sky thousands of years ago, having no idea what any of these objects could be. What are these distant points of light? What is the universe as a whole, and just how big is it? Is it truly infinite? Where did everything come from, including us? These are the grandest questions that humans can dare to ask. And from this perplexity, gnawing at us every time the sun would set, was born arguably the first science, astronomy. As we know from ancient texts, early astronomy dates at least as far back as the first known civilization, Mesopotamia, and probably much further still. These were times when there was no distinction between science and mysticism. For this reason, our initial attempts at answering those big questions about the universe comprise nothing more than elaborate mythologies, campfire stories of creation and other fiction. We saw in the night sky a drama unfolding, much like the one that takes place each day on Earth, and we projected images of earthly figures onto the stars. While much of this activity was nothing but the hubris of man on the grandest scale, it did mark what was probably the first large-scale gathering of empirical data. We came to know the night sky intimately, every glistening star, every luminous object. We charted their movements and slowly became able to predict their locations with great precision, thus deciphering the Earth's seasons and other natural phenomena. While it would be many centuries before we came to understand what these celestial objects truly are, our journey of scientific discovery was spawned of this nighttime wonder. Naturally, astronomy has matured over the centuries, more recently birthing the fields of astrophysics and cosmology, which all come together to represent our detailed study of the universe. Considering where we are at present in the 21st century, we have learned so much about the universe that we have begun to answer even those most fundamental questions about existence. We now have a very firm understanding of how old the universe is, and we even know a lot about how it must have begun. To the non-scientist, this claim seems absurd. How can we know such things? How can we be so arrogant as to even attempt to know them? And yet, we have tremendous amounts of data to support our current model of the universe, actual empirical evidence for what we profess to know. And once you learn about astronomy, the basis for this knowledge can become quite clear, even to the layperson with no scientific training. In this series, we will begin by attempting to describe the basic components of the universe in roughly the chronological order in which they formed. That means energy and the most basic constituents of matter first, then stars and galaxies, then the planets that came to orbit those stars, and eventually getting to more exotic objects and concepts. Once we have covered the basics, producing a comprehensive view of the history of the universe, we will then be ready to get into some trickier specifics. As we will periodically dip into theoretical physics, astrophysics, and cosmology throughout these tutorials, we will sometimes examine concepts that are extremely complicated, but we will do our best to approach these topics in a balanced way. This means we won't go over all of the math, as it's just too much, but sometimes we will assume some rudimentary mathematical knowledge, so it may be useful to check out some of my algebra and trigonometry tutorials if you need a refresher. We will also use many of the ideas we discussed in the classical physics and modern physics series. So, if you want to maximize your comprehension of these tutorials, those will also be important prerequisites. But if you just want to have some fun and learn a few things about space, Don't worry, you can move forward now. And if something we are discussing seems confusing, you can always click on the cards that appear in the corner of the screen for more background information. Whatever your reason for watching this series, once you're through, you will have a solid conceptual understanding of the universe and everything in it, or as much as is available to mankind at the present. As for the questions that remain, maybe you can help answer some of them and become part of the story we continue to tell about the dark expanse above us, the abyss of possibilities that holds the future of mankind in its swirling glow. But enough with the poetry, let's learn some astronomy. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.